SMD resistors are the most widely used type of resistors among the different resistors. And these type of resistors are used in the production of various electronic equipments like television, smartphone and even high-tech R&D equipments. Now, if you closely observe the printed circuit boards of these electronic equipments, then you will find that the small code is written on top of these surface mount resistors. So basically, this code defines the value of these resistors. So now in this video, let us find out how we can decode this code and from this, how we can find the value of these surface mount resistors. Now, usually the three types of coding schemes are used for these surface mount resistors. So let us see them one by one. So the first type of coding scheme is the three-digit coding scheme. So in this scheme, the three digits are used to define the value of the resistors. Now out of the three digits, the first two digits defines the two most significant digits of the resistor value, while the third digit defines the multiplying factor for the resistor value. So now let us take some examples for this three-digit coding scheme. So for example, if the code that is written on this SMD resistor is 223, it means that the value that is represented by this resistor is equal to 22 into 10 to the power 3. That is equal to 22 kilo ohm. So here the last digit is 3. It means that the value would be multiplied by the 10 to the power 3. And hence the value is equal to 22 kilo ohm. Similarly, for the code of 430, the value of the resistor would be equal to 43 into 10 to the power 0. That is equal to 43 ohm. And likewise, if the code that is written on the resistor is 305, it means that the value of the resistor would be equal to 30 into 10 to the power 5, that is equal to 3 mega ohm. Now, sometimes in these three-digit coding schemes, the letter R is used to define the position of the decimal point. So for example, if the code that is written on the resistor is 2R2, it means that the value of the resistor is equal to 2.2 ohm. And likewise, for the code of R39, the value of the resistor would be 0.39 ohm. So basically, this letter R is used to define the position of the decimal point. So in this way, by using this three-digit code, we can find the resistor value. So now similarly, let us see the four-digit coding scheme. So this type of coding scheme is also very similar to the three-digit coding scheme. So in this four-digit coding scheme, out of the four digits, the first three digits defines the three most significant digits of the resistor value, while the last digit defines the multiplying factor for this resistor value. So let us take some examples for this four-digit coding scheme. So for example, if the code that is written on the surface mount resistor is 1001, it means that the value of the resistor would be 100 into 10 to the power 1, that is equal to 1 kilo ohm. And similarly, for the case of 5103, the value of the resistor would be 510 into 10 to the power 3, that is equal to 510 kilo ohm. So in this way, by using this 4-digit coding scheme, we can find the resistor value. Now in this 4-digit coding scheme also, the letter R is used to define the position of the decimal point. So for example, if the code that is written on the resistor is 2R70, it means that the value of the resistor would be equal to 2.7 ohm. And likewise, if the code that is written on the resistor is 0R24, then the value of the resistor would be 0.24 ohm. Now many times in the PCB assemblings, these SMD jumpers are also used. Now theoretically, the resistance of these SMD jumpers used to be a 0 ohm. So whenever you find this type of codes that is written on the surface mount resistors, it means that the value of this resistor is equal to 0 ohm. Now apart from these 3 and 4 digit coding schemes, for the high precision resistors, this third type of coding scheme is also used. So this type of coding scheme is used for the resistors which has a 1% of tolerance. So in this scheme, 3 characters are used to define the resistor value. Now out of the 3 characters, the first two characters used to be a number and last character used to be a letter. So these first two digits defines the three most significant digits of the resistor value, while the last letter used to define the multiplying factor for the resistor value. So here is a table which defines the different codes for the last letter and the corresponding multiplying factor. And here is the another table which defines the first two digits of the code and the corresponding value that is represented by these first two digits. So using these two tables, we can find the value of the resistor for this type of coding scheme. So now let's say we have one resistor and the code that is written on this resistor is 36C. Now if you look this code, the first two digits of this code is 36 and the corresponding value that is represented by that code is 232 and the last letter of this code is C. So the multiplying factor for this resistor would be equal to 100. So from this we can say that the value of the resistor would be equal to 232 multiplied by 100, that is equal to 23.2 kilo ohm. So in this way, by using these two tables, we can find the value of the resistor. So let us take a few more examples so that it will get clear to you. So let us say we have one more resistor and the code that is written on the resistor is 05Y. Now from the first two digits of this code, we can say that the value that is represented by this code is equal to 110. And here the last letter is Y. So the corresponding multiplying factor is equal to 0.01. So from these two tables, we can say that the value of the resistor will be equal to 110 multiplied by 0.01, that is equal to 1.1 ohm. So similarly, let us take one more example. So if the code that is written on the resistor is 48D, then we can say that the value of the resistor will be equal to 309 multiplied by 1000. So the value of the resistor would be equal to 309 kilo ohm. So in this way, by using these two tables, we can find the value of the resistor for this type of coding scheme. So I hope in this short tutorial, you understood how to find the value of the surface mount resistors from the code that is written on these resistors. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.